Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In the series of manual testing tutorials, today we are going to learn what rainbow box testing and what are the types that are involved in the rainbow box testing. So we often hear a lot about white box testing or gray box testing or black box testing. So there are some other testing techniques are also available. So these are not activities or testing types or consider inside rainbow box testing. So let's see what are the different types available in rainbow box testing. So here, if you see, we have white box testing, which is useful for the development team to perform the unit testing of the development code. So black box testing, we often call it as a functional testing. So it happens at different levels of testing, where we have different levels like system integration testing. So like that. So in that, we usually do the black box testing to perform and validate the functionality of the application. So whereas gray box testing is the combination of both white box testing and the black box testing. So glass box testing is nothing but the other name for the white box testing, which is nothing but the unit testing which performs by the development team. Red box testing, yellow box testing, and green box testing. So these are the different techniques which we will learn in this tutorial. So coming to the gray box testing, as we discussed, it is the combination of white box and black box testing. It is a kind of maintenance check. So it is like, suppose if we have any changes or if we have any enhancements to our application, so we regularly go for this gray box testing, where the dev team is working on the white box test cases, that is nothing but the unit test cases, whereas a testing team, QA team, will work on the black box test cases, which is nothing but the functional testing execution of functional testing scripts, and it is performed on internal and the build code, where we will perform the testing. Build code is nothing but the deployed code. So once the code is deployed into the system, so there also we'll have a level of testing that happens in the gray box testing. Okay, so next one is red box testing. So red box testing usually used to check the error messages. So it is one of the part of user acceptance testing, and it is like a protocol checking, and mainly it is used in networks and peripheral testing. So that it is called as network and peripheral testing. So where if you observe while connecting your devices, sometimes we'll get some error messages, like the error which we are seeing on the screen here. I will show you one example. So here I have an image which is related to the WordPress. So here it is showing some error saying the password you entered for the user admin is correct. So this is the type of technique where we use to check these kind of error messages on a web page or an application. And coming to the yellow box testing, basically this yellow box testing is used to validate the warnings of the system over the software. Suppose here, while accessing some applications or the websites in some of the organizations, or while working on your personal PCs as well, sometimes we will see these kind of warnings. So these are the warnings where details also can be tested in the, as a part of acceptance test in the testing technique. So like this, we have the different types of testings involved in the development of software lifecycle. So that's all for now. I hope you understand different types of techniques involved in the rainbow box testing types.